We want to graph the given secant function. We want to find the period, find the horizontal shift, and then graph the function. So before we begin, let's review the key components of the cosecant and secant functions in this form here. Also notice how this piece of the function is in factored form. The first thing to recognize is that the absolute value of A is not the amplitude, because cosecant and secant have no amplitude. Even though the value of A will vertically stretch or vertically compress the function, these two functions do not have an amplitude. Next, the period is equal to 2 pi divided by b, again where this is in factored form. Next, c, this constant here, will vertically shift the graph up or down. If c is positive, the function is shifted up c units. If c is negative, the function is shifted down the absolute value of c units. And then finally d, this value here, horizontally shifts the graph, or translates the graph. Where if d is greater than 0, so this will be in the form of x minus d, the function is shifted right d units. But if d is negative, meaning this would be in the form of x plus d, the function is shifted the absolute value of d units to the left. So going back to our example, the first step is going to be to factor 4x minus 4. So let's go ahead and write this as y equals 2 times secant of, factoring out the 4 would give us 4 times the quantity x minus 1. Notice in this form, b is positive 4, which will help us find the period. And here we have x minus 1, which will help us find the horizontal shift. So the period is going to be equal to 2 pi divided by b, which would be 2 pi divided by 4, or pi over 2 radians. And this is going to be approximately 1.57. And then the horizontal shift, because we have x minus 1, we'll actually shift the graph to the right 1 unit. Remember, if it was x plus 1, it would shift the graph to the left 1 unit. Now that we have the period and the horizontal shift, let's focus on graphing this function. Before we graph the transformation of the secant function, let's focus on some of the key components of the basic secant function graphed here in blue, as well as the basic cosine function graphed here in red. Remember, the secant function and the cosine function are reciprocals of one another. And often it's helpful to graph the corresponding cosine function to graph a given secant function. Notice here in red, where the cosine function is equal to 0, the secant function has vertical asymptotes here, 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 and here. Also notice where the basic cosine function is equal to 1, so is the secant function, because they're reciprocals of one another. So here, here, and here, both functions are equal to 1, and where the basic cosine function equals negative 1, so does the basic secant function. So we're going to use key points on the corresponding cosine function to graph the given transformation of the secant function. Meaning, we're going to start by graphing y equals 2 times cosine of 4 times the quantity x minus 1. This graph will help us graph the corresponding secant function. So to graph this cosine function, we're going to focus on this piece of the basic cosine function from 0 to 2 pi radians here. Notice at x equals 0, the cosine function is 1, then it goes to 0, negative 1, 0, and 1. So we'll use this pattern to graph this transformation of the cosine function. To begin, notice how the graph is shifted right 1 unit, so we won't start at the y-axis, we'll shift the graph 1 unit to the right. So we're going to start our graph here, if this is 1 unit, and then because the period is pi over 2 radians, 1 plus pi over 2 radians would give us one complete graph of this cosine function. So 1 plus pi over 2 radians would be approximately 1 plus 1.57. Let's go and label this 2.57 here. And then just as always, we'll divide this period into four equal pieces. So we'll cut this in half, and then in half again. And now we'll graph these key 5 points of the cosine function. But remember, we do have a coefficient here of 2. So when x equals 1, instead of plotting the cosine function value of 1, it would be 2 times 1, or 2. So if this is 1 and this is 2, we would start this piece of the cosine function here. And then if we move 1/4 of the period to the right, it's going to drop down to the x-axis here. We move 1/4 of the period to the right, we'll be down at a minimum, which isn't going to be negative 1, it's going to be 2 times negative 1, or negative 2, which would be here. And then the next 1/4 will be back at the x-axis, the next 1/4 will be back at a maximum. So here is one period of the corresponding cosine function. It would look like this. Let's go ahead and repeat this a couple more times. If we move to the left another 1.57 units, we can graph another period of this cosine function. If we move to the left, 1.57 units would be approximately here at approximately negative 0.57. So if we divide this interval into four equal pieces, we would be here, here, and here. Following the same pattern, we'll start here to maximum, back to the midline, down to a minimum, midline, and maximum. So it would look like this. Let's go ahead and do that one more time. If we go left another 1.57 units, we'd be back at approximately negative 2.14, which would be somewhere in here. We'll divide this interval into four equal pieces, here, here, and here, and again follow the same pattern. On the left of this interval, we'll have a maximum, then midline, minimum, midline, maximum. And here we go. Let's go ahead and stop here. And now because this is the corresponding cosine function, we should now be able to easily graph the given secant function. Remember, where this cosine function is equal to 0, our secant function will have vertical asymptotes. So we'd have a vertical asymptote here, 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 and here. And now the corresponding secant function will share the same maximum and minimum values of the corresponding cosine function. So starting at this piece here, it's going to pass at this point and approach the vertical asymptote here. Looking at this piece of the cosine function, the corresponding secant function would look like this. Looking at this piece, the corresponding secant function would look like this. This piece would look like this. You can see how graphing this cosine function, while it took some time, is very helpful for graphing the corresponding secant function. Of course, we could graph more if we needed, but hopefully you get the idea. I hope you found this helpful.